That handshake does signal that game two is now about to begin. Brian DeVries kicking things off with a tag call right away in order to start setting up, of course, not only additional tag team Pokemon, but it's the new tag team supporters.
Yep, so he does have access to all of his deck now, pretty much. He's got all of those tag team Pokemon that he plays in this deck, as well as some of those other support cards. We'll have to see if he was able to find a Welder, because that's obviously a supporter of choice that he'd like to start with. Is going to go with that Mewtwo, though, and we'll see what else he finds.
And how about that that starting Pokemon there for Brian? Not exactly ideal.
Yeah. This deck, I believe he's pretty much only playing a few Psychic, maybe, and some Rainbows. So attacking with Espeon Deoxys is going to be weird, and I don't even know if you want to start doing that, because you've got some pretty important GX attacks that you'd like to get off in this match.
We see Reshiram and Charizard as one of the choices here from the tag call, and of course Mega Lopunny and Jigglypuff tag team GX. Mega Lopunny and Jigglypuff is very, very powerful, and specifically if your opponent accidentally overextends his field.
So we'll see if Brian is able to get himself into a little better position here. Does have the Viridian Forest, so can find an additional energy. Gets that Solgaleo with the discard pile as well, so looking for Turbo Strike potentially on the following turn. But I didn't see many switch cards. I didn't see much that's really going to be helping him out here.
Yeah, at this point, Brian kind of just thinning his deck out with that Viridian Forest, discarding, of course, that Solgaleo in order to find himself a Fire Energy. Now, I believe three cards drawn here from Cynthia and Caitlin after discarding a card. Not the most powerful supporter on turn one.
Does find himself Jirachi, but doesn't have access to switching outs. Espeon and Deoxys does have that two retreat cost, so
there's a great catcher in his hand, is Brian, but he's forced to pass, as of course there are no GX Pokemon for Robin. So of course Robin has Jirachi as his starting Pokemon, about the best possible start there for Robin. And when it comes to starting Pokemon, Robin drawing his card for the turn, will he have an explosive turn as we've come to expect out of this Fire deck from
he's
Robin.
Got everything besides a Welder right now. This hand is pretty sweet. He's got access to a few different Pokemon if he chooses to use them, but he has that Dedenne as well. Can get a couple Fire Energies in the discard. Now really just has to make the decision, do I want a Jirachi first and try to find Welder, or do I just Dedenne and just push?
Well, remember when we were talking about potentially overextending into the Mega Lopunny. Right now, we already see three tag team three GX Pokemon from Robin, and a calculated risk there in order to try to find a Welder. Does not find a Welder. Actually, doesn't even find any Fire Energies to go with it. So, not a great hand after that Dedenne's Dedede change.
Yeah, this isn't going to be an explosive turn, but it is going to be a reasonable turn. He does find Ditto along with Zebstrika, so he would have access to get through his deck a little faster if he wanted to. He is at that dangerous point with GX Pokemon, though. He's already placed down three, which means that Mega Lopunny would be doing 240 damage any more, and he's really going to put his Reshiram and Charizard at risk. So doesn't want to play another Dedenne.
We see Stellar Wish here from Robin. Of course, could have potentially used Stellar Wish first. Instead, decided to go for the more aggressive play with the Dedede change. And now, kind of trying to mitigate the damage Robin dealt to himself on this first turn with a Stellar Wish, finding himself a Giant Hearth. At this point, Robin not going to be having that that really big explosive turn that would put Brian in a ton of a pressure situation. So now Brian has to be feeling a tiny bit better about this. But remember, it's not like Brian's hand's any good.
Yeah, I think Robin's now just mapping out his hand. I think he understands that he doesn't want to play any more GX Pokemon. He's probably going to play that Ditto and go into the Zebstrike on the following turn. So this search should be for a Jirachi, and then he can use that either to discard through the Viridian Forest or through the Giant Hearth in the following in the rest of this turn here.
So now, will Robin be ending his turn in just a few seconds? And now we take a look at Robin's hand. We see a Blitz, or was that a Zebstrika?
Yeah, he's just going to go no Zebstrika.
Yeah.
I guess that means that he's going to have to continue through this Dedenne. It's going to be super risky against the Mega Lopunny, but maybe his hand just ends up working out and he can start to find Welders and never have to play the Dedenne. Who knows?
Discarding now Ditto Prism Star to Giant Hearth. Robin really making some unexpected plays potentially.
I mean, I'll never count out his plays. He might just think he's got a better line, and who am I to say? He does have the one wishing star that's already the stellar wish that's already been used, so doesn't have access to Welder this turn.
It kind of feels like Robin believes that the key to this to victory in this matchup is just going to be just all-out aggression.
Well, actually, we do see this switch here, so this is going to be pretty helpful for him. This well, if he could find Welder on this Stellar Wish, then this certainly makes up for everything that's gone down so far. He hasn't found the best cards, but there
one
is
card
the
away,
Welder.
There is that Welder. He does find that Welder off the top five cards of his deck, which will allow him to not only attach two more fire energies, but draw three additional cards. So now Robin's hand getting a tiny bit healthier, and, of course, more importantly, having three fire energy attached at the end of his own first turn. Of course, they are all going to be on this Reshiram and Charizard Tag Team GX, which means that there's going to be a lot of damage potentially coming out of Robin on his own second turn. Brian has to be feeling a little bit of the heat.
Yeah, this is exactly what Robin was trying to go for. He saw that he couldn't go for this safer approach with the Zebstrika. Instead, he saw that he had access to that switch with the Jirachi, so he could take that risk, potentially finding the Welder. It pays off huge for him. Now he does have that Pokemon that could potentially hit for 300 damage into a Mewtwo soon.
Robin must have been feeling the nerves as he was starting to look through the top five cards of his deck from that Stellar Wish, because if he did not find that Welder, he would have been in definitely a little bit more dangerous shape than he's in now. Now, Brian starting his own for second turn, and now we're starting to see him begin to power up his Pokemon. But remember, he still has that Espeon and Deoxys tag team in the active position. There's just a lot of uncertainty out of Brian's hand.
Yeah, he actually goes ahead and uses that Stealthy Hood on his Mewtwo and Mew GX. This means that he won't be able to get dragged up by the Ninetales, Nine Temptations. It's usually a card that we see being used for other matchups, but it does provide a benefit here. It also kind of speaks to what Brian feels his hand's going to be. He's not taking that risk and getting aggressive. He thinks that this Mewtwo's going to need a little time to relax on the bench before it comes up and tries to attack into that Reshiram and Charizard tag team.
We were speaking to the uncertainty in Brian's hand, so he was forced to Dede change, and Dede did draw him six new cards into his hand, but there's still no switch effect, I don't believe.
Yeah, it's starting to look pretty rough. The Espeon and Deoxys is one of the worst starters that you could have in the active spot there, and he just hasn't found a way to move. He'd really like to start using his Jirachi, and as Robin's setting up, Brian could do that as well, but just going to have to keep on pushing through, uses that giant hearth, and it's going to pull some fires out of the deck. But
yeah, Tag Call actually found a Guzma and Hala and a second Mewtwo and Mew Tag Team GX before doing so, and Giant Hearth looks to be only finding one fire energy here. So these resources starting to deplete here for Brian, and just more importantly, that it's such a strange situation that Brian finds himself in.
Yeah, looking at the rest of his hand, there's really not much happening. Robin could have an explosive start. Unfortunately, does find that Turtonator again. He kind of wanted to just put that back into his deck and not see it until he needed it again, because if he wants to go aggressive, that's not going to be helping him much. This Megalopunny is going to go to the bench now. He's going to try to use Jirachi to keep on fishing. Looks like he will have extra time now because Brian has had such a slow start, but still looking for Welders.
Marshadow discarding itself at the end of Brian's turn in order to get rid of that giant hearth after Brian had kind of maximized his own usage out of the card. Now Robin starting with a Jirachi Stellar Wish here. Of course, we've already seen three energy get attached onto the Reshiram and Charizard. Will we see three more, for example, and then really pressure Brian? There's lots of plays available to Robin, especially after being able to use Stellar Wish for a third time before Brian can even use it once.
We could see two more. He already had to retreat.
All right, there's a switch here from Robin. That's the card of choice out of that Stellar Wish.
Yep, switch is kind of like the reset button. If you miss the Welder, you just try again with your other Jirachi, and that seems to be what Robin is going to be going for here. Really just not much going on with that hand. Even if he had access to a giant hearth or something to just start to move through his deck a little bit faster, I feel like he'd be okay. Sometimes you're allowed to miss the Welder, especially when you know you're not going for that big attack on this turn.
So if he's not going for the big attack on this turn, what's he trying to do? What kind of a setup is he trying to achieve?
Well, he's likely going to be passing with Jirachi in the active spot, and he would like to have the Welder so that he could get the energies on board and not have to have the Welder on the following turn. I'm sure those energies would be going to the Reshiram and Charizard and really just threatening a huge knockout, but It's really tough to tell right now what Robin's plan is, because he didn't get to draw the cards in the right order. He had to retreat a Mega Lopunny. He's finding Welders right at the end of the turn, so all the decisions coming in beforehand don't necessarily add up.
So that is the second Stellar Wish of the turn here from Robin, and it does find him another Welder there. So it seems like the second Stellar Wish on both turns, just kind of finding the optimal card for Robin. And of course, Welder, we've seen on the previous turn how it lets you not only attach up to two fire energy on one of your Pokemon, but of course also draws you three cards. So it's just kind of like the perfect little engine there.
Yeah, it's going to attach to his Mega Lopunny and Jigglypuff. It is threatening a reasonable amount of damage here, but it's neither of these Pokemon are going to be attacking just yet.
Yeah, and not only is it threatening, you know, a ton of damage, but it's also kind of putting Brian in an even more uncomfortable situation where he can't really keep benching more Pokemon, right? Like, at this point, Brian just has to beware of not only the Charizard, but of course the mighty Jigglypuff.
Oh, yeah. It's certainly a mighty Pokemon.
And that is the end of Robin's turn. Jirachi waking up at the end of Robin's turn. Brian now still with that Espeon and Deoxys tag team active there. And we see that Jirachi just raring to go. It's so eager to get up there to start wishing. But without a way to become active, it's just not happening for Brian.
Yeah, this has truly just been a really awkward game for Brian. He doesn't really have anything going for him. He might have to use an escape board along with an attachment for the turn to finally get out of the active spot. This is not where you want to be.
Well, you're not wrong here, but I mean, does Brian have some sort of a option here in order to really make a game out of this? You don't want to go down 2-0 against Robin here in on the Championship Sunday stage. You want to give it your best shot, right? So what can Brian do to start coming back here?
Well, he's in a tough spot. If he wants to start accelerating energies onto a relevant Pokemon, he'd have to bench a Mewtwo and Mew. And that means that Mega Lopunny gets to run over just about anything on his field. So he's going to have to work with the Pokemon that he has or pick the right opportunity to sneak this Mewtwo into attacking. And I don't really know when that opportunity comes. It's pretty frightening when, you know, Robin has access to pulling up every Pokemon besides your Mewtwo with that ability on the Ninetales. It really just depends if he starts to sense some weakness over on Robin's side. Maybe he thinks the hand isn't as strong, and maybe he starts to pull in then, thinking this isn't a turn where he has Welder, or if I don't play this GX Pokemon, then I'm not going to walk right into this Mega Lopunny.
So, of course, Mega Lopunny already dealing 240 damage. So any additional GX Pokemon will reach that 300 damage threshold, which, of course, is going to be enough to knock out anything on Brian's field. So you're absolutely right. There's kind of like a what-can-I-do situation. Do I bench another Pokemon and then allow my opponent to one-hit KO me, or do I try to work with the resources that I have here, which are just not great? All of that has to do with starting with Espeon and Deoxys tag team.
Absolutely. If he didn't have to start this Pokemon, then he'd have, hypothetically, if he had another Mewtwo there, then he could start using Turbo Strike, maybe get some energies onto there as well. If one of these Mewtwo were to fall, then he could start using his Charizard's GX attack and take a big knockout, but instead, he just has to play this game of chicken with a guy who can just pull up anyone he wants at any time, and that's not where you want to be.
Now, here's the other part, though. Robin's already used a couple of Welders, right? So he doesn't have the optimal amount of energies on either, well, specifically on the Reshiram and Charizard. So maybe there's potential for you to have one turn of, you know, coming up with some sort of, like, aggression if you're Brian?
Yeah, it really just, You have to do it before you play a GX Pokemon, because you have to just hope to dodge Welder and not walk right into the attack of the Charizard. But when's that opportunity coming? I'm assuming that he's going to have to try this next turn then with some help from his Jirachi. And on that same note, maybe Robin's starting to sense that my opponent really isn't doing much. Should I bring my Mega Lopunny up and just see what he's got? If I find my Welder, I'll just win the game with a 300 double blaze.
Of course. Now, Brian, on the other hand, doesn't even have a great catcher available to him to kind of bring the fight to Charizard before Charizard can bring the fight to it. So who's going to knock out a Jirachi first, really? Like, that's really the big question, right? At least right now.
I think these guys are content just using their abilities and hanging out.
You say content. I feel like one of these players is content. The other player is kind of wishing he had more options available to him, is Brian. But, of course, Robin, you're absolutely right, is content to just kind of wait the play out, right? Like, what's the worst thing that can really happen to him?
Right.
If his opponent even finds a great catcher, okay, deal 120 damage to my Charizard. I'll allow it.
Yeah, I mean, as soon as Robin finds Welder, I feel like there's no reason for him to take his foot off the gas. So he's just going to hang out until that happens. Taking a knockout on Jirachi with the Megalopunny could then open him up to taking a tag team knockout and then using Ninetales to take a smaller GX knockout on like a Dedenne, and that could be the way that he wins the match. So for Robin, he's just going to plan out accordingly. He knows if he uses Welder, he's going to have access to two energies at that time. So this energy attachment is going to go to Megalopunny in case something wonky happens off of a reset stamp or who knows what.
So neither player has taken a single prize in this game. It's really kind of been an awkward back and forth exchange from both Brian and Robin, but it seems like both of these players are just inches away from starting to get some sort of aggression going. So despite the kind of standstill that we're in, it seems like at some point in the near future, we're going to see a lot of explosion coming from both of these players.
He didn't find a switching effect.
Still no switching effect.
He's got multiple cherish balls. He doesn't want to use them because he doesn't want to play another Dedenne down and not only lose all of these energy cards, but also set yourself up to walk into Megalopunny. So I think he's going to pass again.
Just doesn't want to do it. You can kind of feel it in the air that Brian is just so hesitant to just pass the turn, but there's nothing he can really do about it. Despite not wanting to do it, it seems like there's no real choice here for Brian. So now Brian does pass the turn over to Robin. Does Robin have something going for him? Will Robin now be the first one to attack?
Yeah, really, this really all lines up with his Jirachi. If his Jirachi can find him a Welder, then he can use that Welder, and if that Welder draws him into a switching effect, then I feel like Robin may take the first blow here, just knowing that his opponent really hasn't done much. You wouldn't be removing a GX from the field, so you wouldn't be opening up that slot for Brian to start to use Turbo Strike. Everything adds up if Welder finds switching effect.
Now, Robin looking at the top five for that Stellar Wish. Seeing a skateboard.
It's a lot of switching effects, but yeah. that's not the Welder yet.
No, it's not the Welder, but I think if it's not Welder, you're fine with an skateboard. Of course, you prefer the Welder.
Yeah, I mean, this skateboard opens up Jirachi to then retreat to the other Jirachi, and he's in the exact same position, except the switching effect would have to literally be a switch.
Right.
So but now, what's the rush?
Yeah, of course. It's not Robin who's under the pressure of really starting to rush. Though there is some danger out of having three energy now on that Mewtwo and Mew. There's definitely something to be said for that. But that's just about the only real threatening thing Brian has going for him.
Right. As soon as you get to three energies, that means one more could walk into Great Catcher and having that 300 damage from the Charizard GX attack into your Reshiram and Charizard. So that could be a little scary for Robin. Maybe he then feels like he needs to start getting aggressive, but
yeah, I think that Robin's feeling like he's no longer safe anymore. There's definitely the potential, despite Brian, of course, not having done anything aggressive up until this point, but still feels like he's in a very good spot. However, if we see, say, something like a one-hit KO onto the Megalopunny, then at this point you can just start building up your board, right? And so if your opponent even gets a 300 damage KO onto your own Mewtwo, if you have any kind of response, which is going to be the big question, then you can make a game out of this, Ken Brian. But either way, it's going to involve a big one-hit KO out of Brian.
We are just going to see the energy attachment from Robin and passing the turn.
Robin again passes the turn over to Brian. Brian's Jirachi wakes up. Still no switch effect for Brian, so force the Stellar Wish right away. I see a reset stamp.
Yeah, that's not doing much for him. He does have these Cherish Balls in hand. He could be using those to thin out his deck and then maybe give himself a little better odds to find the switching cards, but maybe he's just worried about stacking up a big hand and eventually just having to throw it all away with Dedenne. Man, he's going to have the energy for his Mewtwo, but I don't even know if he's...
Is there a Charizard GX in the discard pile?
Who knows?
I don't believe so.
I don't think that he really got to accomplish very much.
But, of course, Cherish Ball can find that Charizard GX as long as it's not prized.
Yep, and then he should have access to the Giant Hearth if he wants to do that.
So it seems like as long as the Charizard GX isn't prized, he does have that available to him. Everything else, though, is what he doesn't. Does he have a Great Catcher in hand? Did you get to take a look at that?
I did not see, but he has been drawing, he's been grabbing a lot of specialty cards, specialty item cards with his Jirachi, just not the switching effects that he's been looking for, so certainly could be holding on to one of those. Also, we know he does have that reset stamp, so if Pokemon were to start falling soon, maybe he could set up a pretty sweet combination where he puts Robin on a bad hand and takes a big GX knockout. A
lot of questions still left to be answered out of Brian's hand. One thing we do know, though, is he cannot retreat that Jirachi or get the Jirachi to the bench in any way. So Robin now allowed another basically free turn, and you can see how small Robin's deck is getting. So between all of these Stellar Wishes with such a small deck, I would be very surprised if Robin doesn't have optimal plays from here on out.
Yeah, we do see that he was only able to grab those two energies. Those are the last energies in his deck now. I believe he is sitting on 12 to 13 cards now. Fiery Flint's absolutely useless, but... he can hold that maybe for when Victini starts to come back into play. Really hasn't been able to get that many Fire Energies in the discard pile because he has four in his prizes and he hasn't been taking any knockouts there.
And he has seven in play.
Yeah. There is Welder, though.
Yeah, big Welder found from Brian. Already has seven energy
Robin.
In play. Correct, I'm sorry, Robin. Already has seven energy in play, but why not add two more to that already large pile of energies in play? Eyeing potentially another card like maybe Switch, but no, Welder's got to be the choice here, right?
Yeah, he's really thinking about it. I mean, his deck is so low that he should have access to Welder throughout the rest of the game. I think he just doesn't want to play the energies onto the Reshiram and Charizard until he's taking a big knockout. For instance, if he was taking the knockout on the Mewtwo. So now he feels like he can take the risk. It doesn't mean that he's not going to get aggressive this turn. He certainly could use the Mega Lopunny, take the knockout, bring that Pokemon into the active spot, and then say, hey, you need to answer this with a Mewtwo.
Is there any merit to knocking out an Espeon and Deoxys?
It's three prizes. That's pretty cool. But other than that, he doesn't have enough fire energy to close out the game with Victini. He would have enough fires to close out the game with Turtonator, however. So that could be a potential resource for Robin to look into soon.
Robin does indeed actually take the escape board with his Stellar Wish. You could actually see him racking his brain over it. And now that escape board allowed a second Jirachi to Stellar Wish here.
Yeah, Robin has thinned out his deck almost to the point of no return now. He has Palpad, four Welders in that deck, and the deck is probably in the low teens of cards left. So
at most, I think.
Every time that he uses Jirachi, that's almost a guaranteed Welder, so he feels content not having to use that Welder.
That's the end of Robin's turn. Robin's Jirachi stays asleep. Brian's Jirachi wakes up. Still no top deck switch effect. Now we're starting to see that Cherish Ball. We're starting to actually see him being Brian, potentially thin his deck to have a better shot at switching. But remember, he already has four energy on the Mewtwo, so I don't think you even need a switch anymore. You can just retreat the Jirachi if you don't Stellar Wish.
Yep, he has slowly but surely gotten himself to this point. If he has the Great Catcher, then we certainly could see Brian take that big knockout on the Reshiram and Charizard.
So does he have a Great Catcher? He has a large hand, so there's always the potential for that. Found the Charizard GX with the Cherish Ball, so it was not prized, which was very important for Brian's potential strategy here. Mewtwo and Mew slowly but surely been building energy. Now ready to potentially Flare Blitz GX to deal 300 damage and, of course, knock out anything on Robin's side of the field. But does he have the Great Catcher in order to bring up one of these powerful Pokemon that Robin has been building up on that bench?
He's eyeing up Dedenne.
Dedenne potentially going to be able to draw cards here for for Brian. But remember, Dedenne would be another GX Pokemon that would come into play. That's a lot of danger here.
Yeah, this is terrifying. He would walk right into a knockout, and I'm not sure if he's even going to do it. It's so many resources that would fall.
So he could just play it passively and go for a Stellar Wish. He does go for a Stellar Wish here. Now, Stellar Wish finding a Welder. Welder's actually not a bad card to find here. Now, here you can actually, you've already built up your board to the point where you can just say, okay, let's just play another Mewtwo and Mew. We're going to accept the fact that the Mega Lopunny will one-hit KO me, but if I can just keep trading one-hit KOs, and if I'm the first one to do to achieve that one-hit KO, then maybe I can pull this off.
Yeah, Brian even counting his deck out now, thinking about potentially using the Welder. Not even sure where he'd want these energy, honestly, unless
probably
this is the turn that he completely commits to the board. I mean, if you're going to let your opponent do 300, you might as well let him do 360, right? So he could play all the GXs and
that's
just
correct.
go.
So, okay, that's the Welder. Welder onto Mewtwo and Mew Tag Team. Do we draw three? We draw a Switch. Do we draw a Great Catcher with it? There's an energy. There's the Switch, but there's no Great Catcher in sight. Reset Stamp resetting Robin's large hand down to six. Very rarely do we say that after a Reset Stamp.
Yeah, this is, he's going to draw into a bunch of Welders and stuff. Robin's like, oh, okay, sure. this is fine.
So that Reset Stamp tells me that he is really ready to play that Dedenne.
Yeah, we do see the Charizard GX is going to hit the discard pile now, so 300 damage is a potential option for Brian with that 4 energy Mewtwo.
So if he plays Giant Hearth, maybe he wants to thin one fire energy out of that deck, maybe only leave one left for himself, which means we're trying to maximize our Dedenne's chances at getting this Great Catcher. Plays this. Oh, man, this is so dangerous. High risk, high reward play out of Brian here, potentially.
Robin can hardly cut Brian's deck because it's so small.
Brian still mulling over his options. It's not too late to turn around. That's what he's thinking. Now it might be, as we do see that switch onto the Mewtwo with only 3 energy on it. And here's the Dedenne changing, finding 6 new cards. Very few cards left in the deck. Does Brian find what the card he was looking for?
I don't think we see a Great Catcher.
I don't see a Great Catcher myself. I only took one quick glance at it. I see Mysterious Treasures. Oh, man. Did he miss? Remember, his deck is only something like 4 cards. Did he miss the Great Catcher?
Yeah.
Giant Hearth. I don't see a Great Catcher. If it's the Great Catcher, it would have to be the last card in his hand. And I do not believe it is. Brian potentially just missed here. Mysterious Treasure. We're going to look at the last few remaining cards in his deck. And the last card in the deck was the Great Catcher.
Yeah, he has just the one in there. He was trying to take out the Mega Lopunny so that he could take those 3 prize cards, give himself some of those cards that are in the prizes, and then he knows that Robin is very likely to use that Reshiram and Charizard to try to clean up, and then he'd have his big stealthy hooded Mewtwo to clean the game. But in this spot, you don't want to knock out a Jirachi.
You've already used your Switch. You have very few resources left. You have 1 fire energy left between your deck and your hand.
I mean, it was almost a pure 50-50 at that point with 11 cards there, and he was going to find 6 of them, and he just missed.
He maximized his chances as much as he could. He even got rid of one of his second-to-last fire energy from his discard pile, and now only uses Solgaleo's attack to bring even more energy onto that Mewtwo and Mew, and takes 1 single prize card. He feels like that's the only opportunity that he truly has on this turn. So now Robin, facing down so many GX Pokemon, will undoubtedly be able to knock out this Mewtwo and Mew in return.
Yeah, for Robin, this lines up pretty great. Even if he could find his Turtonator, he could start to use that as an attacker if he wanted, but obviously Mega Lopunny's a pretty great attacker in this circumstance. He could just come up and take a 360 damage knockout.
A plethora of options for Robin here. Which choice will he go with? You feel like Brian just had his best possible opportunity to take this game and miss completely. You say 50-50. I think it was slightly slightly edged towards him.
Yes, it
actually
was.
Actually achieving success, but that great catcher just did not want to be found. We saw him look for it over and over again, turn after turn, but he could not find it. One of the problems of great catch, despite it being so powerful, is that you tend to run it in really low numbers because of its drawback and because it only brings out GXs. So having access to only two of them and then maybe potentially having one prize just really, really puts you in awkward situations when you're trying to go for the game. And Brian uncomfortably had to take a knockout onto a single Jirachi. Will Robin now return the knockout onto now Mewtwo and Mew? Robin finding a Pokemon communication with that Stellar Wish.
He has communication, and this means that he could put the Dedenne back in, maybe find the Turtonator if he wants to, because he knows he's going to have so many energies on board. This with attacking with the Mega Lopunny, that means that you have three energies that would be safe if your opponent did find that Great Catcher and go after your Reshiram and Charizard, and that means that you're just a welder, two energies, and attachment away from being the Latin American International Champion.
Turtonator, the Pokemon of choice here from that Pokemon communication. We see Explosive Jet just such a powerful attack because it can one-hit KO big tag team GX Pokemon like that Mewtwo and Mew that we see uncomfortably in that active position here for Brian.
Robin is holding on to a few fire energy. He's got exactly three. There's none left in his deck. Four in his prize cards.
He knows that it's actually impossible for him to miss a fire energy from his prizes.
Yeah, he's been in this situation before, and he has a lot of fire energies in those prizes. He is going to be very excited to see those after taking these prize cards from Jumping Balloon for an ridiculous amount of damage.
Over 300 damage done by that Jumping Balloon, and that's three prizes taken by Robin Schultz. Robin, one tag team knockout away from being crowned the Masters Division Latin American International Champion. Brian, down to a single Mewtwo and Mew with a ton of energy on it. Will he be able to take six prizes with it, though? We see five energy on that Charizard. There's just no way, is there? Brian looking for a way. We see a reset stamp. Maybe if you get your opponent to not draw fire energy, is that your best opportunity?
With a giant hearth in play? Maybe not.
Oh, man. Can you get rid of that giant hearth? Maybe not. He's already used his Marshadow.
Yeah, I think Robin set up a pretty nice checkmate. If Brian even uses the Great Catcher to take out the Reshiram and Charizard, the Megalopunny's doing enough damage now to win the game. He would attack for 300.
It already deals 300. Correct.
Take out the Mewtwo and Mew, so that's not a way to win. You need your opponent to forget that Giant Hearth is a card, but Robin's played it almost more than anyone in the world, so he's not going to forget that.
Marshadow, unfortunately for Brian, already gone. That would have been a great card to get rid of that Giant Hearth, but instead, we see a Mewtwo and Mew. This is desperation mode here for Brian. There's so many attacks available to Mewtwo and Mew right now. There's got to be one, right? One that gets you out of here. That's what Brian's thinking as he searches frantically through his discard pile with so many GX Pokemon. Are we going to see an extension of the hand? Are we going to see Mewtwo and Mew bravely get one last knockout in before Robin can be crowned champion? Looks like that's going to be the case. Nope. Still going through the discard pile.
Does he have GG End in there? I'm trying to figure out how you do this one.
And there's the handshake. Robin Schultz crowned your Latin American International Champion.
Woo. Congratulations to Robin. That deck is pretty phenomenal, and it took a lot of guts to bring that to this tournament, especially with the way that it had been performing throughout all the rest of the tournaments that we've had just this season alone. And he said, you know what, this was the right call for Worlds, and it's going to be the right call for Latin America. He is your champion. And, of course, Brian put on a pretty great show for us as well. I'm sure he's going to be cursing the name of that Espeon and Deoxys for a little bit, though.
I'm here on the stage with your Masters Division Latin American International Championships champion. Please give a big round of applause for Robin Schultz of Germany! So I'm going to start with probably an obvious question, but it needs to be asked. How are you feeling right now after that incredible win?
It's feels a bit weird after playing only one game in the finals. But yeah, still, it's like great winning this. And yeah, I'm happy.
Yeah, I'm sure you are. Now, if I'm not mistaken, you winning this Internationals means that you now won of like every single type of event, from like World Championships all the way down to, you know, League Challenge and League Cups. So having that full, you know, that full set of accomplishments, how much does that mean to you, or is it more just like it's just another event to add to your resume?
Well, I haven't won a regional championship yet, at least not one of the new ones, so I guess that's still something to aim for. But yeah, like I haven't like fully like realized like just I won, I guess. It's like pretty crazy.
I mean, you know, when it comes to when you have this level of accomplishments, I guess, you know, perhaps not winning in regionals doesn't matter as much, but I'm sure you'll be able to win regionals in due time as well. Now, just one last question to end us all off. Now that you are the international champion, what are you going to do next? What are your next year hopes and dreams? Is there anything else you'd like to do, or, you know, where do we go from here?
Guess I'll just continue doing what I do, like playing all those tournaments, going to internationals. It's always fun coming here, playing. Like, yeah, and I don't think I will stop anytime soon.
That's great to hear. And actually, maybe one last question that would be good to ask is, for everyone watching at home and in the audience, what sort of advice would you really give to them that if someone were to home and think, wow, that could be me one day, I could be an international champion, what would you say to that person to help them get there?
I think the most important thing is just playing a lot, and then like with experience is quite important, I feel like. And with time, if you put in the work and try to find your mistakes, success will come your way.
A great and humble answer from a great and humble player. Please, everyone, one last time, a massive round of applause to Robin Schultz, your international champion for the Trading Card Game here in Latin America.